Welcome to Snake Island. In the last episode, I flew to Isla Culebra and started my venture at the world-famous Flamenco Beach. With limited provisions, I hiked northwest on Flamenco Peninsula and built a simple shelter mostly from materials I found on the beach. It was a really difficult night due to an infestation of biting midges, commonly known as no-see-em bugs, but other than that, the night was unbelievably gorgeous. This episode begins with a gorgeous sunrise, but underneath that celestial beauty lies the deadly threat of dehydration as I struggle to find a reliable source of water in this arid landscape. I knew from viewing satellite images that there are a few coconut palms on this part of the peninsula, so I wasn't too worried about finding water. But the question is, do they have coconuts?
There's fruit on that tree. Somebody's hideout. All those little trash treasures that storms have brought up in the past. There's no fruit. Wow.
Someone's campsite. Looks like it's kind of fairly recent.
I don't want to be poking around too much, but I don't think it's used anymore.
Get there. Sally, you're the most beautiful thing I've seen all day. When I get the chance, I'll get you some makeup.
I couldn't help seeing faces in all the coconuts washed on shore, so I picked one up and I named her Sally. Then I packed up and I hiked towards the point with hopes of finding water.
Could definitely be used to make something.
Thank you. For a moment, I envisioned myself paddling through the waves in this boat, but after a closer look at the damage it suffered, I realized that would be impossible. It definitely wasn't seaworthy.
It's really hot.
The boat was a really cool find, but unfortunately, it was in really bad shape and definitely not seaworthy.
I would love to have some sea grapes. Let's see. Come on, let there be some sea grapes. Shoot. So many sea grape plants, but the fruit's all green. Yeah, it's all green. I really need to get a source of water. I'm getting thirsty. I still have one coconut and approximately 1 liter of water left. That's it. There's my source, my favorite cactus.
Pipe organ cactus is my emergency source of water in Isla Calabria. But on the way, I found an unexpected potential water source.
Oh my gosh, I wonder if it's good. Be really risky to drink it. Unless it could be so good. The bottle's been opened before. Oh man. I'm sure it's about 100 degrees. What should I do? Just smells like plastic. Yeah, I couldn't drink this. I don't think it's particularly good to drink. It's gonna be the cactus. The cactus I like to eat is called Plosocereus roenii, or commonly known as organ pipe cactus. And I also see another one that sometimes provides me some fruit. And that's called Turk's cap cactus, also known as melon cactus. The melon cactus is right there. Oh, it's a really beautiful cactus. Unfortunately, it has no fruits. It's barely gonna flower. Let me check these others up here. Just flowers.
Darn it.
Wait a minute. How did I miss that? Look at it, already ejected a fruit. I'm sliding all over in these cactus. Ow. Got some thorns right there. I gotta be careful. I'm trying to shoot a video and hike at the same time. It's really no easy task. Fortunately, my feet are pretty rough and tough. The melon cactus, the Turk's cap cactus, it gets this little tiny pink fruit. It tastes a lot like pitaya or dragon fruit. Very similar in taste. Little tiny seeds inside, same texture and everything. So a nice tasty little treat. Carefully get it out of here. Yeah, where they come out of here when after the plant flowers, it'll produce the fruit, and then the fruit gets ejected out. I'm unfortunate to find this one caught in the spines. It's good.
It's just so little. I want more. My God, what luck. There's another one. Delicious. Delicious. A handful of those at the same time would be so good. There's my cactus. Getting to this cactus is, it's no easy task. This is what Culebra is known for. Lots of spiny, thorny shrubbery. Okay. Ouch. That's the only problem with sandals. And then I'll chop it off right here in the middle. Look at that. This is all edible. It's just full of water. What you do is you peel off the skin. Once it's all peeled, it's good to eat. Okay, get him to squeeze the water out. When you're really thirsty, this actually tastes really good. It's quite similar to cucumber. Juicy like it.
The cactus helped relieve my thirst, but not for long. I really needed a source of pure water to drink, not just vegetables to eat. But without rain or coconuts, there's no other source of water. So far today, I've traveled about halfway to the point. The coastline then became more rugged and more difficult to traverse, and I often had to change course. Then I spotted an old Sherman tank, an old relic from the U.S. Navy occupation of Isla Culebra during much of the last century. Due to difficult terrain, I had to find a different route at this point.
The brush is too thick and thorny over there. I can't get through. I had to come back.
Once again, I felt super dehydrated and there was no sign of pipe organ cactus around. My only remaining water source was one small coconut I saved from Flamenco Beach. And then...
oh, it's so beautiful. That's where she camped tonight.
The view from this point was spectacular, but my main concern was water. I had only taken in about a liter and a half of water all day, which is less than half the recommended amount in these conditions.
This site is incredible. Wonder how many people have seen this. Look, we got Turk's cap cactus all over the place. Oh, it's so good. Oh, and here's another one. Now, if it would just rain, if it would just rain today, it'd be perfect. Looks like it might rain. That's rain out there. I don't think it's coming directly this way, though.
There's a lot of fruit here. This one actually has three. Oh, that one's already been eaten a little bit. It's still good, though.
Love these. Mmm. There's another one.
Look at that, caught by the spines. And there's one on the ground. It's good.
Mmm. Oh, I hit it good here. Another one. It tastes so delicious. Mmm. Oh, it helps. It helps soothe the dryness in my throat.
The melon cactus fruits were very tasty and they slightly helped relieve my dehydration, but the water content in them is quite insignificant. It was now time to drink my last remaining water and hope for the best.
Less than an hour ago that I put these up here. You see a lot of condensation's already begun, but I don't have time. I don't have a reliable water source here. I've got to find water. I'm completely out right now. So the situation has just become critical. I think I've eaten just about all the Turk's cap cactus fruit that there is. There's a few more here.
Help just a little bit to quench my thirst. This one's really in there.
Just put my bag over there. Turn around, I came back, so I spotted the cactus up there. I'm completely out of water, I'm so thirsty. Something with water in it. That's all there is. My first time here, I was cussing like crazy when I was in these kind of situations. Having to crawl through this brush on the ground. I've improved a little bit over the years. Whoa, look at that termite nest. Wow, there could be a big meal in there. If only I had a bowl, a fire and water, and I could make a termite soup. There's my cactus. That looks like a good stem. I hope I feel a lot better after this. Just looking at this cactus makes me feel better already. It gives me a little reassurance. So I'm going to add a little bit of water to my body. Oh. This will probably be the last source of water I have for the rest of the day. Oh, that water looks so good. I'm going to go sit in the water while I eat my cactus.
Somehow, just being in the water helped relieve the feeling of dehydration, but only temporarily. I felt the waters reinvigorating both my body and my spirit. And I was even having fun, but then my reality returned. Several times I thought to myself, what am I doing out here? When watching this, it's really hard to understand or sense the intensity of my thirst. All day I drank less than 2 liters of water, which is far less than the amount needed on a hot day hiking in full sun exposure. From my provisions, I ate 3 hard-boiled eggs, 1 avocado, 1/2 coconut, and 1/2 nutrition bar. The rest was cactus. Nonetheless, I continued towards my goal, the northeast point, where I hoped to spend a night free of biting insects. And along the way, I found something else.
I'm not thinking fishing. I'm thinking bedding. This could actually be really good to sleep on.
I decided not to use a fisherman's net, but it sparked my curiosity as to what other useful materials I might find here. It felt surreal to not see another human being all day. I didn't even see any boats pass by. I was totally isolated and very vulnerable. And then I made it to the point, and fortunately there was plenty of wind to keep the insects away. But where to sleep was the question. But I decided to deal with that after a quick swim.
That was a successful trip. All right, I got a few things. I got a few treasures. First of all, I was walking down the beach. I went to get cactus, but on the way I found this. And so, what is it? I don't know, it looks like a hatch for a boat or something. But I'm gonna use it as a bed to sleep on this rocky shore. And then tomorrow I'm going to use it as a boogie board. So that would be interesting. And then I also found these berries produce they have a very red juice. And we're going to use that as a makeup for Sally. She's going to love it. And then I found a friend for Sally. I don't know what her or his name is yet. We'll work on that though.
Amazingly, my needs were basically met. Water was still a concern, but at least I found a nearby source of cactus. My bed worked quite well and was far more comfortable than if I had tried sleeping on the rocks. All alone at the tip of Flamenco Peninsula, I put my concerns aside and enjoyed the moment while chewing on cactus. The sounds of the sea mixed with the visual masterpiece of the sky and silhouettes of rocky caves that soon faded into the night were replaced by the splendor of a starry night with small clouds drifting by in the steady breeze. It was an unforgettable night. On the next Snake Island survival adventure, I used my bed from the previous night to explore the sea, and hope is restored when sprinkles of rain produce drops of water I hastily collect. But still later, I feel the effects of dehydration as my muscles start to cramp up.
Trapezius, I can't even lift this.